I mean, look, we're at such a unique point of the industry in terms of turning of events, right? The opportunities with streaming and CTV are clear. It's the future. It's what consumers are leaning towards. It's what the market is interested in spending dollars in that direction. It represents a tremendous movement of how we think about overarching video dollars in the sense of television and the evolution of what that looks like. Now, the challenges are real, right? The world started in a linear perspective, and you're not going to be able to get the tonnage from an efficiency standpoint in CTV, which automatically opens up a conversation around online video, mobile, social, and so forth. So the reality is that we're at this inflection point of where the market is interested in consuming content and where advertisers are interested in spending content, but it's not a one-size-fits-all story for a video strategy, which incorporates then linear, streaming, and OLV as we think about the evolution of the overall investment strategy.
You had some big news today with Coachella. Tell me a little bit about this partnership and what some of the benefits will be for the marketplace.
Absolutely. So, look, the relationship that we have with Coachella is a long-standing partnership that finally we were able to bring our vision together to market. And the background of and kind of the principle of what this stands for is the reality that every single channel has its role in the performance outcome that advertisers are expecting in their ROI story. It starts with deduplicated reach and frequency, but it ultimately concludes with purchase events. Inherently, linear gets lost a little bit in that conversation from the attribution standpoint, from the performant nature. Right? We know we can understand how we think about reach metrics, but how does that actually parlay itself into purchases, registration? The relationship between Comscore and Coachella represents this combination of big data sets that allow for us to make sure that linear is not lost in the attributable outcome part of the story that marketers are obviously optimizing against in these new digitally oriented channels in and of themselves. So it's really about bringing linear into that performance story and give it credit where credit's due.
Who would be your customer for this service and what sort of benefits would they get from using it?
Yeah, I mean, look, it's really a two-sided scenario in that situation. Ultimately, it really starts with the brand marketer, right? And being able to drive that attributable ROI-driven outcome that they're looking to, you know, or not looking to, frankly, expect to see from the media that they're spending dollars against. But on the flip side, it's a tremendous opportunity for those providers at the national and the local broadcast side of the picture to be able to talk about the role that linear continues to contribute, both from a cost efficiency standpoint, but from a performance standpoint into that marketing ROAS story. So really, it's multi-sided in that capacity. And it tells a great story of making sure that everybody that drives a part of the outcome equation is part of the rewarded team that is ultimately being driven investments.
What are you excited about in the year ahead?
I mean, I just think, you know, we haven't seen this level of tremendous change in the market since really the introduction of smartphones, or we think about, you know, the role of audience-driven programmatic that kind of came about, you know, a decade ago. I mean, we are at truly an inflection point about how we think about cross-channel media consumption from the eyes of the consumer. And it's fueling the innovation that we're seeing across the market, whether it's buy-side or sell-side technology, measurement innovation, or investment strategies on behalf of the clients. And we're finally seeing this thing come together.